السلام عليكم.
وعليكم
وعليكم
السلام.
السلام. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Today we shall discuss, inshallah, hadith number 1894 of Sahih al-Bukhari. Kitab al-Sawm. About fasting. Sawm means?
Fasting.
Bab Fadl al-Sawm. Bab, under the kitab, Bab Fadl al-Sawm. That is the superiority of as-Sawm. That is fasting. Superiority of fasting. Hadith. حدثنا عبد الله بن مسلمة عن مالك عن أبي الزناد عن الأعرج عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال الصيام جنة فلا يرفث ولا يجهل وإن امرؤ قاتله أو شاتمه فليقل إني صائم مرتين والذي نفسي بيده لخلوف فم الصائم أطيب عند الله من ريح المسك يترك طعامه وشرابه وشهوته من أجلي الصيام لي وأنا أجزي به والحسنة بأشر أمثالها. Narrated Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu reports this hadith from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال certainly messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said الصيام جنة صوم fasting is a shield. جنة means
shield,
a covering. فلا يرفث ولا يجهل. فلا يرفث, so hence a fasting person should not do any obscene acts or should not do sexual intercourse even with his wife. Then وَلَا يَجْهَلْ, and he should not behave impudently, or he should not behave foolishly. Foolishness. He should not behave foolishly. وَإِنْ اِمْرُعٍ قَاتَلَهُ أَوْ شَاتَمَهُ. Then if any other person comes to or approaches this fasting person and abuses him or fights with him or come and ready to fight with him. Okay. Then فَلْيَقُلْ, then this fasting person should say what? إِنِّي صَائِمْ. That means
I am fasting.
مَرَّتَيْن.
Twice.
Two times. So two times this fasting person should say inni swa'imun. That means the fasting person should not attack the other person. Okay. He should avoid a quarrel. Okay. He should take steps not to avoid quarrel. Then walladhi nafsi biyadihi, and by him in whose hands is my soul. Means by whom? وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدْهِ means by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahi. He said that this Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدْهِ, by him who in whose hands is my soul. Means Wallahi, by Allah, I say لَخُلُوفُ فَمِ الصَّائِمِ, the smell coming out of the mouth of a fasting person. The smell coming out of the mouth. Fam means
mouth.
The smell coming out of the fam, mouth of the fasting person, is atyabu. It is better andallahi, near Allah, in Allah Ta'ala, min rihil misk. That is better than the
musk.
Smell of
musk.
Misk means musk. Kasturi, Malayal. Yatturku ta'amhu. Then Allah says, that is, now Allah speaks. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam quoting. Yatturku ta'amhu wa sharabahu wa shahbatahu min ajri. Allah says about the fasting person. Yatruku, he avoids, he gives up what? To'amahu, his
food.
Wa sharabahu,
drink.
His drink. وشهوته. His
abundances.
Or his evil thoughts like that. Shahwat. Shahwat. Min ajli, for my sake. For my sake. It is for Allah's sake. As suyamu li. And then suyam, fasting is for me. Wa ana ajzi bihi. And I will reward for that. I will reward for that. Wal hasanatu bi ashri amsaliha. Wal hasanatu. And a virtue, a good thing will be bi ashri amsaliha. It will be equivalent to 10 times. That is, one good deed will get at least 10 times reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay. Now, we shall see, inshallah, the sharah, that is the explanatory notes given in Fathul Bari, li Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, that is, الصيام جنة حديث ومن ثم آخره حديث وجمعه عنه هذا هكذا القعنبي وعنه رواه البخاري هنا ووقعن غير القعنبي من رواة الموطأ زيادة في آخر الثاني وهي بعد قوله وأنا أجزي به والحسنة بأشر أمثالها زادوا إلى 700 ضعف إلا الصيام فهو لي وأنا أجزي به. وقد أخرج البخاري هذا الحديث بعد أبواب من طريق أبي صالح عن أبي هريرة وبين في أبره أنه من قول الله عز وجل كما سأبينه. Now, in some reports, we see, a good deed will get the reward from 10 times. So here, in this report, وَالْحَسَنَةُ بِأَشْرِ أَمْثَالِهَا. A good deed will be equivalent to 10 times its reward. Or, a good deed will be given the reward its 10 times. Then, here, you see, in some other reports, it is like this. Wal hasanatu bi ashri amsaliha. And a good deed will get the reward 10 times. Bi zadu ila sabi'u mi'ati dhi'af. Then, ila sabi'u mi'ati dhi'af. That is, up to 700 times. Alpha means?
100.
Alpha.
Thousand.
Mi'at?
100.
Sabi mi'at?
700.
Sabi mi'at alpha? No, alpha here no. Here, sabi mi'at. Sabi mi'at 700 times. Alpha, 1000. So, sabi mi'at means? 700. So, a good deed will get the reward 10 times to 700 times. Illa suyam, except fasting. Fahuwa li, and that is for me. Wa ana ajzi bihi, and I will reward for that. That means fasting will get reward without any limits. Okay. Other good deeds will get rewards from 10 times to 700 times as according to its natural, that is, its kabooliyat, as Allah wills. Okay, then. Qawluhu, As-Siyamu Junnah, Zada ibn Mansur, Sa'id ibn Mansur, An Maghirat ibn Abdul Rahman, An Abi Zinad, Junnatum min al-Nar, Walin Nasa'i min hadithi Aisha mithluhu, Walahu min hadithi Uthman bin Abil As, As-Siyamu Junnah, كجنة أحدكم من القتال وليحمد من طريق أبي يونس أن أبي هريرة جنة وحسن حصين من النار وله من حديث أبي عبيدة الجراح بن الجراح الصيام جنة ما لم يخرقها زاد الدارمي بالغيبة وبذلك ترجم له وهو هو وأبو داود. No. What do we mean by الصيام جنة? By the word as-suyam junnah. Suyam, fasting, is a junnah, a shield. What is meaning? Here, different explanations are given. What it means? One is this. It is a shield from the hellfire. As-suyam junnah means Abu Zina disease. Junnatum minanar. It is a shield from the hellfire. Say, from the
hellfire.
This. Abu Zinad. Nasai. Abu Zinad and Nasai. Abu Zinad. As per the report of Abu Zinad. Abu Zinad and Nasai quotes this. From the hadith of, as per the hadith of Aisha radiallahu anha. Now, another one. جنة كجنة أحدكم من القتال الصيام جنة كجنة أحدكم من القتال that is it is a shield from the hellfire how it is a shield as you use in the wars so in the wars from to prevent the attacks to defend to prevent the attacks from enemy various fighters use Shield to protect the sakhum, arrows, to prevent the arrows coming. So, in olden days, shield was used. So, just like that, shield used in the wars. The soum, fasting, will prevent you from the hellfire. Okay. This is according to Usman ibn Abul As hadith. Now, another explanation. Abu Huraira reports, Junnatun asiyamu junnatun wahisun hasweenum minannar. And siyam is a shield. So fasting is a shield. Wahisun hasweenum minannar. Hisun means fort. Hisun al Muslim. Muslims fort. Fort quota. It's a hisun hasween. That means it's a safe fort for the Muslim, for the Swaim. Suyamu Junnatun Wahisrun Haswinum Minanar. It will be a safe, a protective fort from the hellfire. You know, kings will be in the fort. Kings. Or then, if the fort is well protected, a well-built, well-protected fort, then enemies, for enemies, it will be difficult to attack the kings, king inside. Okay? You know? Then, like that. So, hisnun hasweer minannar. This, it will be a protective, a safe fort for the swaim, for the person who fasts from the hellfire. Okay? It will be a fort, a protective or safe fort from the hellfire, annar. Then it is according to Imam Ahmad's reports as per the hadith of Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. Now, in Darimi's reports, we see that the fasting will act as a junnah or shield against the hellfire if one, only if one break the reward of fasting, if one, do not break the reward of fasting by ghibat or backbiting others. Like this. It is. Malam yakhriqha. Malam yakhriqha. If he do not collapse or break the fast bil ghibati with backbiting. So, if one person perform fasting or observe fasting, then he is backbiting others. He is telling something wrong about others. Others' sins, others' errors. He is publishing. Then, his fast will not be acting as a junnah against the hellfire. Okay? So, in Darimi's report, it is like that. Now, والجنة بضم الجين الوقاية والسطر وقد تبين بهذه الروايات متعلق هذا السطر وأنه من النار وبهذا جزم ابن عبد البر وأما صاحب النهاية فقال معنى كونه جنة أو يقي صاحبه ما يؤذيه من الشهوات. Now, From the above reports, we may come to the conclusion that fasting acts as a protective shield or covering from the hellfire. From this, we can understand fasting acts as a protective covering or a shield from the hellfire. Now, the author of Nihaya holds that fasting guards the one who fasts from evil thoughts. So, Junna means here Junna from evil thoughts. A sutra or a barrier or a hindrance, a wall against the evil thoughts. So, the person will be protected from evil thoughts. Then, thereby, he will be protected from the hellfire also. Okay. وقال القرطبي جنة أي سترة يعني بحسب مشروعيته فينبغي للصائم أن يصونه مما يفسده وينقص ثوابه وينقص ثوابه وإليه الإشارة بقوله فإذا كان يوم صوم أحدكم فلا يرفث إلى آخره ويصح أن يراد أنه سترة بحسب فائدته وهو إضعاف شهوات النفس وإليه الإشارة بقوله يدع شهوته إلى آخره ويصح أن يراد أنه سترة بحسب ما يحصل من الثواب وتضعيف الحسنات. Now, Imam Qurtubi quotes that fasting is a junnah. It means that it is a shield or covering or sutra, and as such, it is expected that the one who fasts, the one who performs or observe fasting, should keep himself from such acts that may lead to reduce the reward of fasting or make it void, make it debatil. So the fasting person's duty is to protect the fasting. Okay, the fasting person should not indulge in any evil deeds, even evil thoughts. Then only he will get the right reward. Otherwise, the reward will be reduced. Okay, the reward will be reduced. Then only, so if he gets perfect reward, then only it will act as a junnah or a sutra. So the fasting person should abstain from evil deeds and evil thoughts. Okay, follow, yes. So this is clear from the words of the hadith. That is, in another report, فَإِذَا كَانَ يَوْمُ صَوْمِ أَحْدِكُمْ فَلَا يَرْفُثْ. The day you fast, Prophet ﷺ says, the day you fast, you should abstain from rafas or obscenity or evil deeds, evil acts. The day you fast, you should keep away from obscenity or rafas, like that. No. وقال غياض في الإكمال معناه سترة من الآثام أو من النار أو من جميع ذلك وبالأخير جزم النووي. غياض in الإكمال says fasting is a shield or covering from the hellfire or from آثام. إثم جمع آثام. إثم means
sins.
Sins. إثم
name.
إثم ثعل. If my sin. So fasting is a shield or covering from sins or from hellfire or from both. Okay. This is the view of Qiyad. Now, وَقَالَ إِبْنُ الْعَرَبِي إِنَّمَا كَانَ الصَّوْمُ جُنَّةٌ مِنَ النَّارِ لِأَنَّهُ إِمْسَاكٌ عَنِ الشَّهَوَاتِ وَالنَّارُ مَحْفُوفَةٌ بِالشَّهَوَاتِ فالحاصلو أنه إذا كف نفسه عن الشهوات في الدنيا كان ذلك ساترا له من النار في الآخرة. Now Ibn al-Arabi says that is إنما كان صوم جنة من النار. Suddenly fasting is a shield from the hellfire because لأنه إمساك عن الشهوات, it is protective against obscene acts, against شهوات, his body, what his body thinks. From that, the body is protected from the shahwat by the fasting. By fasting. So, the body, the nafs, is protected from shahwat. So, that's why. فَالْحَاسِلْ. Then we get, what? أَنَّهُ إِذَا كَفَّ نَفْسَهُ عَنِ الشَّهَوَاتِ. If one can protect one's nafs from shahwat, from obscene acts, from evil deeds, then it will be in this world, here in this world, if one can protect his nafs from shahwat, from obscene acts, from evil thoughts, from evil deeds, then he can. It will be acting as a satir, as a covering, as a shield in the akhirah from the hellfire. Okay, so if one can abstain from evil thoughts or evil deeds or obscene deeds from because of his fasting, then it will surely act as a satir or sutra or a shield in the hellfire, from the hellfire in the hereafter. Okay, follow. وفي زيادة أبي عبيدة ابن الجراح إشارة إلى أن الغيبة تضر بالصيام وقد حكي عن عائشة وبه قال الأوزاعي إن الغيبة تفطر الصائم وتوجب عليه قضاء ذلك اليوم. Another report from Abu Ubaidah al-Jarrah and Aisha radiallahu anha indicates that backbiting or ghibat will damage fasting. Backbiting or ghibat will damage fasting. Hence, Imam Auza'i says that, or he holds the view that backbiting or ghibat will make the fasting void or batil. It will break fasting altogether. Then the person should make it again, make it over, or make up the fasting again at another day, that day's fasting. So if one person perform or observe fasting during in one day, then he backbited or he told a lie like that, then the person's fasting will break, then he has to qada the fasting another day after Ramadan. Okay, this is the view of Auza'i Imam. Okay, now wa afrada ibn Hazm فقال يبطله كل معصية من متعمد لها ذاكر لصومه سواء كانت فعلا أو قولا لعموم قوله فلا يرفث ولا يجهل ولقوله في الحديث الآتي بعد أبواب من لم يدع قول الزور والعمل به فليس لله حاجة في أن يدع طعامه وشرابه. Ibn Hazm holds the view that all the sins deliberately done by the fasting person, whether it be potentially or verbally, fi'li or qawli, potential action, fi'li, qawli, verbal action, oral actions, then keeping in mind that he is fasting, he know that he is fasting, still he did that act, evil act, knowingly, not forgetful, okay, knowingly or deliberately he did that evil act, knowing that he is fasting person, then it will make the fasting invalid. It will make the fasting batil. Who views that? Like that, Ibn Hazm. And he arrives at this conclusion. Ibn Hazm arrives at this conclusion, at this decision from the prophetic words. فَلَا يَرْفَثْ فَلَا يَجْهَلْ. You should abstain from rafath or obscene acts, and you should not act foolishly. Like that. من لم يدع قول الزور والعمل به فليس لله حاجة في أن يدع طعامه وشرابه. In another report, Prophet says, Allah has no need from a person to give up his eating and his drinking unless he gives up his bad words and deeds. So fasting person should avoid his all evil actions or evil thoughts or evil deeds, evil words like that. Otherwise, Allah has no need for that person to give up his drinking and eating. Simply starving. No benefit at all. Okay. So from this hadith, Ibn Hazm says that a fasting person, if he deliberately do any evil deeds, then the fasting will be void or invalid. Okay. والجمهور وإن حملوا النهي على التحريم إلا أنهم خصوا الفطرة بالأكل والشرب والجماع، وأشار ابن عبد البر إلى ترجيح الصيام على غيره من العبادات، فقال حسبك بكون الصيام جنة من النار فضلا. Now, still most of the scholars hold that although it is haram or prohibited for a fasting person to do any bad deeds, fasting will be void or invalid only by eating, drinking and sexual intercourse. This is the view of many of the scholars, most of the scholars. But it will affect the perfectness of fasting, the reward of fasting, it will be affected. But the person need not perform or observe the fasting after Ramadan or other days. Okay, no need of qada. This is the view of many of the scholars. Now, وَرَوَى النَّسَائِي بِسَنَدٍ صَحِيحٍ صحيحٍ عَنْ أَبِي أُمَامَ قَالَ قُلْتُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ مُرْنِي بِأَمْرٍ أَخُذُهُ عَنْكَ قَالَ عَلَيْكَ بِالصَّوْمِ فَإِنَّهُ لَا مِثْلَ لَهُ وَفِي رِبَادٍ لَا عَدْلَ لَهُ وَالْمَشْهُورُ عِنْدَ الْجُمْهُورِ تَرْجِيحُ الصَّلَاةِ. Now, there is one report from Abu Umama recorded by Nasa'i where Prophet ﷺ says to Abu Umama that there is no act of worship as the like of fasting. Most of the scholars hold that Salah is the most virtuous worship or deed, act. Amen. Afdalul A'mali as-Salah. Now, قَوْلُهُ فَلَا يَرْفَثْ means what? أي أَصَّائِمُ كَذَا. So that portion, you shall take that, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.